Yo, what's up everybody, welcome back. Today we are going to talk about Pokemon Go spoofing on iOS and Android and how to get Pokemon Go spoofer on iPhone or Android in 2024. So as you can see here, I have a Pokemon Go spoofer on my iPhone and you can access features such as Pokemon Go joystick, teleport, auto walk, all of these many cool features I'm going to talk about today. And if you want to try this on your iOS or Android device, you can check out my guide on my website, where you can find all information about Pokemon Go spoofing and how to install Pokemon Go spoofer, how to use all of that. So check out my website if you want to try it. And I'm going to show you this today, how it actually looks like. I'm going to show you on my iPhone, but everything is the same on Android. This Pokemon Go spoofer is called iPogo in particular. And here in the settings, you can enable features you want to use, such as tap to walk, spoofing, joystick, and stuff like that. So let me show you. Here I have a joystick and I can move around the map. So I can move into any direction with this, as you can see. Also, I can just tap on any part of the map and I'm gonna move into that direction. This is really useful for people who can't walk, or for disabled people, or if you can't go outside, you don't have mobile data, or you just want to play Pokemon Go from home without walking, without moving, you can use these features to actually do that. And with this speed option, we can choose how fast we are going to walk. I recommend you to use lower speed so everything looks as natural as possible, and be careful, of course, there is no 100% safe Pokemon Go spoofer. Also, there is teleport feature. We are going to map and then we type the location where we want to go. Press search and then just hold your thumb on the screen like this until this menu pops up. Now press teleport, press OK, and in a few seconds we'll be teleported to that place. So give it some time for whole map to load, for Pokemon to start appearing and everything. It can take up to a minute or a couple of minutes. But what is really important is that after you teleport, you will probably get 1 or 2 hours of cooldown. You will not be able to see Pokemons or anything like that. Or if you see them, you will probably not be able to catch them. They will fly away always. So after you teleport, you should close the app completely, come back after 1 or 2 hours, and then play. Of course, it's going to be suspicious if you go from one continent to another in like a second. And of course, you should close the app for up to 2 hours and then come back, and everything should work fine. You should be able to catch Pokemons and play normally. So just to play safely, to avoid cooldowns and stuff like that, problems, bans and all of that, you should, after you teleport, you should close the app for 1 to 2 hours and then come back. So with Pokemon Go teleport option, if you live in a small place and if you don't have enough Pokemons to catch, that you can't attend bigger events, you can go to bigger place and then play there, catch Pokemons, attend bigger events and stuff like that, and that can be really useful as well. So all of these Pokemon Go spoofing features are available with installing Pokemon Go spoofer on iOS or Android. And if you want to learn about that, check out my website that you can see on the screen. There you can get my guide for Pokemon Go spoofing and how to get Pokemon Go spoofer on both Android and iOS. And let me know in the comments if you tried, how it went, what do you think, and let me know what do you think about Pokemon Go spoofers in 2024. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.